Hi guys, this is Sunita. Welcome to your class. Class 11, chapter 2nd, We Are Not Afraid to Die If We Can All Be Together. Written by Jordan Cook and Alan East. Part 1. So let us start. First of all, before starting the chapter, we are going to just see the important topics of the things which are required to understand the chapter. First of all, this is a boat in a storm, which is stuck in a storm. Okay, so this is the condition of a boat if a boat is stuck in a storm. This is for storm jib. Okay, so this is storm jib, which will be discussed here in the chapter. This is waterproof hatch. So let us continue now. Some important topics. This is the island where at last the writer and his family will reach. It is an island of inhabitant of 28. So next is, this is deck of a ship. This is the inner cabin. These are the inner cabins of any of the ship, any of the boat. This is life jacket. This is oilskin, which a fisherman usually wears. And here is the map with us. We are going to study the map first before starting the chapter. So through the map, I'm going to tell you the summary of the chapter. What is the summary of the chapter? But before that, let me show you the pic of a boat. Okay, this is a particular boat which is made of wooden. Okay, in the chapter, we have in the same way, a boat was designed by the writer and his wife, which was professionally designed, which was made of wooden, and so it is here. So let us continue now. This is Plymouth. Plymouth is in England. Okay, and this is Cape Town. Mr. James Cook did this sea journey. Okay, and the writer of our chapter wants to duplicate the sea journey which was done by Mr. James Cook, Captain James Cook. Okay, so in July 1976, the narrator, a 37-year-old businessman, his wife Mary, 6-year-old Jonathan, and 7-year-old daughter Suzanne, started their sea voyage from Plymouth. Here it is, Plymouth, England. They wished to go round the world on a long sea journey, just as Captain James Cook had done 200 years earlier. The narrator and his wife had spent 16 years preparing for the round the world voyage and improving their marine skills. Their boat Waywalker was a 23-meter 30-ton boat that was professionally built, and they had tested it in the roughest weather they could find. The first part, actually this story, this is an autobiography, extract of an autobiography. So this story has been divided into three phases. First phase is the preparation, how to start the journey. Okay, second phase is here, from Plymouth to Cape Town, which was a very pleasant part of the journey. Okay, and the third part is from Cape Town to an island, Amsterdam. So this was the toughest part of the journey. So here in the chapter, we are going to discuss about all. So the first part, actually the journey was planned for 3 years. And the first part, the first part of this 3 year planned journey was good. Okay, the journey from Plymouth to Cape Town, it was nice, it was very pleasant. But as this sea was very rough, so they thought to have some help, and so in the same way, they hired two two crewmen, the American Larry Vigil and the Swiss Herb Segler, before heading east from Cape Town to help them tackle one of the world's roughest sea, the Southern Indian Ocean. This is Southern Indian Ocean. So, actually, on the new year, in 1976, they started their journey, and in December, till December, it was in July they started, and till December, everything was fine. This journey was of 105,000 kilometer. Total, the journey was of 105,000 kilometer. First part was this, and they had to cover the whole world. They had to round the world. So, now, from Cape Town, they started their journey, and they were 3,500 kilometers away from Cape Town up to now. So, the Christmas, they celebrated there only. Although the winds were strong, but they celebrated the Christmas enthusiastically. The New Year, they hoped for the change up to New Year, and of course there was a change, but that was for worse. On January 2, it was 3 days suffering. On January 2, it was the first day when the storm hit the boat, and the condition was drastic. The whole family was suffering, and it was very hard to save the lives of the family for the author. In January 3, they were continuously putting their efforts to save the lives. On January 4 as well, they were doing it, and on January 4, they took their first meal in the last 36 hours they were doing, because there was water in the boat, hatches were required, the motor pump stopped to work. Finally, he found a electric water pump, and then they started the work. And on January, he found that with this boat, with this condition of boat, it was impossible to reach Australia. This is Australia. They wanted to reach Australia from Cape Town to Australia, but they thought it was impossible to reach Australia with the condition of the boat. So they decided that they are going to reach the nearest island. So that was in Amsterdam, and if the luck would be with them, then they would reach. So the compass was not fine, they lost the things, they lost instruments and tools, but still they managed. The writer calculated, and then he instructed Larry, and then he unknowingly he dozed off. On January 5, when he woke up at 6 p.m., then he got to know, he thought that they missed the island, and he was very panicked. But his daughter Suzanne and his son Jonathan informed him that they had found the island Amsterdam, and it was quite fine. So this was the whole, and later this 28 inhabitants of this island, they helped the writer and his family, and later it was managed to go to Plymouth, and they could not complete their journey as Captain James Cook. So now let us read the chapter line to line in next part. Thank you. Have a nice day.